Hello everyone, this is Colleen with Yarn Wars on Facebook and yarnwars.com, and I am here today to make some revisions in our Olaf nose. This pattern for this nose is, I don't want to say it's impossible because this is what I did, but I have to say that it is something I made to work, and I had a lot of tugging, pushing on the into the stitches. It was tough making the nose. As I mentioned in the pattern, if you had an easier way of doing it, if you found, you know, maybe making a couple other stitches in there would be easier for you to go with that method, because this part of the pattern was not easy for me at all. The way I'm starting with the nose is with a magic circle. Remember, one time around and then two times around, crossing over. Let me see if I can focus in a little better. All right. And then we're going to come up into the middle between the crisscross and pull that yarn through, twist it up, grab this yarn over here, and pull it through your loop. Okay. So we have our magic circle. And these are the revisions I'm making. If you see this video, I'm going to also put this in the pattern, and I just have to apologize for those of you who have downloaded and printed the pattern and are just struggling with this. I should have put up a video sooner for it, but the nose was just, it was one that was going to be tough. It's going to be tough either way. But what I'm going to do is single crochet. I am using a D hook, okay? Very small hook. And we are going to single crochet 6 into this magic circle. Before we did 4. Three, four, five, and six. All right. Go ahead and pull your tail to close this up. Don't worry about closing this all the way. It's actually probably going to be a little easier for you if you don't close it all the way. Give you just a little more space. And for the nose, because it is such a small working space, make sure that the right side that you're working is facing you, that you're not working this inside out, because I don't even know what to tell you if you get to the end and you have to flip it all through. I don't know how you'll do it. So anyhow, we're going to go into each of the stitches. We'll go into our first stitch, go around, and do a single crochet in each stitch around. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4. Five and six. Okay, we are going into our next row here. We just made 6 single crochets. Let me see if I can focus in better here. All right. We're going to work another round with 1 single crochet into each stitch. And this is going to be very tight, so be patient. And it's hard for me. 1, 2. Three. There's five if I can get it. Splitting my yarn. There's five and six. Let me see, one in there, and oh, can't reach in there. As you can see, the space is so tight. That's why I tell you, if you have another way to make a cone nose, I would go with your way. Okay. And a lot of the shape of his nose is how you form his nose. So at this point, we're going to make this smaller. And this is where it gets really tight. But we are going to go ahead and do two together, single crochet, and we'll just do it into this first one, the first two stitches here. As you can see, we just have kind of a jumbled mess of single crochets here. Here's the bottom of our project, which is going to be attached to Olaf's face. So I'm not even going to bother, obviously, with an invisible decrease on this because it is such a tight space. Pull that out of my way. But we're going to go into our first stitch and pull through. And then we'll go in to our next stitch. This is where it gets fun. We can find our stitch at this point and pull through. And once you are able to pull through, you're going to have three strands on your hook. You'll yarn over and pull through all three to make our decrease. Okay, so from here, we're going to do our best to work a single crochet into our last four stitches, or last, not four, I'm sorry, into the next two stitches. There's one. And see how fun that is. I'm sure you're not real happy with this pattern right now. But in my defense, I did this for one particular person, and from there, this was just it was a labor of love, and I just decided to share it. So, and then our last two stitches, we're going to do one more decrease. Okay, so our stitch here, we're going to go into this stitch and this stitch. It's a little hard to see, but this is going to be where it really is going really to test your patience. Maybe don't even push your hook up all the way through, because you may not be able to pull your strand up, and then go in to that next one. Ugh. And come through. If you can believe I started this with four stitches before, and it was so hard with that. So I don't even know how I did that, because with six, it's tough. And then you're gonna yarn over and pull through all three of those. So we've done two decreases in this last row. And you can see we're coming up to a little bit of a point there. And at this point, I'm going to just pull through, I'm gonna chain. Right there. And we'll go ahead and snip it off. Give yourself a tail. This is where you're going to want your tail, because the start here ends up, the way you're making this, it ends up coming up through the middle. So we'll pull that through, and this is the top of our nose here, and you can use the string that started out in our beginning. You can just pull that a little tighter if you want. Just pull it up and hold the rest of your nose so that you kind of close off that bottom a little better there. Okay. So that one, this is really not going to go anywhere, because you're going to be stitching this to Olaf's face right down here. And then we're just kind of stitching, hiding our tail all the way to the bottom. And when you hide this tail, the one we ended all of our stitching with here, we'll use this to attach our nose. So just real quick, I'm going to get a smaller needle than I usually use for my hiding, because I've got such a tight, I've got tight quarters here. I'm going to only hide this bottom tail just enough to get it out of the way so it's not up there. I'm not too concerned with, you know, making sure it's secure and all of that, because it's not going anywhere. As a matter of fact, if you want, you can just kind of go into any of the stitches around it with your blunt needle, or not blunt needle, and just go in and push straight through the bottom, and then just pull it through. Okay? And that way you can cut it off down here at the bottom part, and then that's going to be sewed onto Olaf, so nobody will ever see that. We'll take the other end, our ending yarn piece, and we'll go, there's just a little space here in the nose that's a little more open because of our twisting around. I'm just going to come down in here, and I'm going to weave it into these stitches coming down my nose. Just go through. It's fine that it's on the outside, because this is what we're using to sew everything up. Okay, and see how we end up with a little carrot nose. And really, if you look at it, it is just like a, it ends up being like an incense cone. If you have an easier way to make this, by all means, I would definitely do that, because this is, it does get frustrating. Right, and I'm going to take it all the way down. I'm going to weave it all the way down to the bottom. Okay, and then from here, I'm going to place this, and explain the best I can here. When you place Olaf's nose, that's also helping to give you a little form right here with his lip a little more. So you want to sew the nose on so that it's like right, almost like pressing down on his upper lip. So that's where his nose is going to be sewn in place. You're just going to stitch that on there, and then you'll know where to place your eyes and do your eyebrows and all that stuff. I am sorry for this complicated mess of a nose, but this is my revised nose to make it a little less difficult. But like I said, if you have a better way of doing it, definitely use your way. And go ahead and ask me any questions you may have in the comment section below. And I'd love for you to come visit us over at Yarn Wars at Facebook. And you just get there from www.facebook.com/yarnwars. Or you can come to our group page, which houses all of the downloads. You may have already been there. facebook.com/groups/yarnwars. But we'd love to see you there. Thank you so much for your patience with this portion of the pattern, and I am around if you need help. Have a great day.